Walter.
Introducing you to Walter, and we are happily camping, still in Little Haven, Pembrokeshire. It's very sunny today. We're going to go down to the beach, but we have to wait for the tide to go out for us to access the beach. So I'm going to do a little stretch for the legs. So this is going to be great, just generally if you, I don't know, just need a bit of a stretch, whether you've just done a workout, whether you've done a big walk, whether you've been for a run. So it's just going to really help open the hips. It's going to stretch the hamstrings, going to stretch into the groin area. It's just ace. And we'll do a little bit of work in the ankle and calf. Excuse me. So let's begin on all fours. So making sure that the hands are underneath the shoulders and the knees are underneath the hips. And we're just going to do like one cat-cow, but we're going to have a slightly different focus. So first of all, as you inhale, just take that extension. So keeping the neck in line with the spine, making the spine nice and long. And then as you exhale now, start to round through the back. So lowering the pelvis, round through the back. And then here, we've talked many times about engaging the core and really drawing that belly button into the spine. So continue to do that, but now also press every part of the body that's in contact with the earth, press down into it. So hands press down, shins, tops of the feet. Really press and feel the body lift up. Quite a strong move. Inhale, extend. Exhale, let's do that again. So press those shins down, press the feet, press the hands. Draw the belly button in. And take the hips back slightly. Nice long stretch through the spine. Oh, that's nice. Okay. So coming up to a kneeling position, I will spin around so I can see you. And you can stay like this. If it's not for you to stretch your leg out, then you can just stay in a high kneel. If you can, you want to take, let's say, the left foot out, toes pointing forwards, but keep the body lifted, keep the body tall. So you're still in line from this knee straight up. Inhale, take the right hand up. Exhale, tilting over and feel that lovely stretch through the side body, but also into the legs. Breathe into it. And then come forwards. Take the hands down in front. Keep the legs as they are. And do that rounding through the spine again. So pressing down into the feet, into the shin, into the hands. Inhale, extend. Lengthen through the spine. Feel that in the inner thigh. Nice. And exhale, rounding up. Walk the hands back, come back to your kneeling position and swap sides. So draw that knee in, take the other one out. This is a really stony ground, but it's okay, got a bit of padding. So make sure you're nice and lifted. Foot out to the side, and then taking the left hand up. Stretch up, and as you exhale, stretch over. Oh, that's nice, need a good old stretch today. Camping life, seizing up. Okay, and then drop that top shoulder forwards. Come back onto all fours. So it's like a cat with a strange leg. Inhale, extend through the spine. Exhale, pressing into the hands, pressing into the shin, pressing into the foot. Arch up. Inhale, come forwards, extending, and exhale, rolling back. Walk the hands back, come up to a high kneel position, draw that leg in, and then we're going to step the right foot back so that you're on the toes of the right foot, and then just rock forwards and backwards so you'll feel a nice stretch in the calf, in the Achilles, in the shin, through the foot. It's lovely. So while you're doing this, just be aware of the rest of your body. Make sure that your shoulders are wide. Your hands are nice and wide, nicely spread on the ground. Belly button just drawn slightly into the spine to lift. Oh, that's nice, isn't it? And then we're going to take that right foot back, draw it in front, and we have options here. So you can come into that kind of position, so where your right foot's about in line with the left knee, and you can stay here, or remember the mast. You can come back into the mast. So you might want some padding for your knees here. If you don't like that, do a runner. So your runner, like so. So you can stay there, really stretch that psoas muscle. Okay, so in the mast, lifting chest, feeling nice and tall. Taking my right hand to my right knee, and then inhale, taking the left hand over and behind, looking behind. So we're getting a lovely stretch through the hip in the psoas muscle. And through the chest. We're always working everything, you know. Inhale, bring it back. I'm going to do that again, but I'm going to include another option. If you've got funny knees, do not do this. So as I lift up, I'm going to bring my foot out to the side. So rather than kneeling on my foot, my right foot is now coming in front of the body. Hey Barney! So this is Pigeon, and although it's an amazing stretch to open out through the hip, it's not for everybody at all. So here, oh, Barney's come to join. Lower down if that's for you. If it's not, you want to stay up here. If you're staying in the mast, just keep that foot underneath the bottom and you can repeat the mast. So if it's in your ability, you can start to drop forwards and rest in there, really, really strong in the hips. Breathe, and then if you're in the mast, you're going to come back to the front. If you're in pigeon, you're going to press down into your hands, curl the back toes, and take that leg back out, back onto all fours. Okay, let's just give our hips a little wiggle from side to side. Maybe stretch back. Let's do a little bit of gentle movement. It's very hot for Barney. He's thinking, what on earth is going on? This is bonkers. Okay, so from here, stretch the left leg onto the toes and rock backwards and forwards. This is such a lovely stretch. I just think doing this is just so nice. Yeah, just might be mindful of the knees. If you need to pad out the knees, then just do that. And obviously, if it's too much on the wrist, come up onto fists, onto the knuckles. From here, we're going to take that foot through. So we're coming into mast, or if that's not for you, coming into a lunge for runner. Okay, so we're going to do it twice. Second time, option for pigeon. So find your level. Start with mast first. Lifting the body upright, taking my left hand to my left thigh. Just be careful that the lift is coming from the thoracic spine here, so we're lifting up here. We don't want to overextend in the lower back. Inhale, paint that beautiful rainbow, and look behind. Bring the arm back. Option here for pigeon, you can repeat mast, or you can do the runner version. Arm movement is the same. Or if you want to do pigeon, then I've just brought my shin across the front of my body slightly, and then I'm just lowering so that I'm comfortable. And it may be that you just want to stay nice and tall, really focus on that opening in the hip. It's really strong, and also you're putting you've got funny knees, your knee might not like this, so just really listen to your body here. It's absolutely not for everybody. And one side might be okay, the other side might not be. So I'm just gonna come forward a little bit. It's a funny one, this. Some people just fall into it and like, what's all the fuss about? And other people, it's just agony. You can come forwards. So it does feel uncomfortable, but it shouldn't feel painful in any way. So it's a really strong stretch, so just really listen. Listen and feel, people. And if you can, you might want to lower the head down. Barney's just lowering his head down. It's like it's too hot for all this nonsense. Okay. Nice one to start. Bringing yourself back to the front if you're in mast. Bring the arm back over. If you're in pigeon, lifting yourself up. Curl the back toes and then take that foot back. And come back onto all fours. Little shimmy from side to side, and then would any leg stretch be a leg stretch without downward dog? I don't think so. So curl your toes, lift your knees, and then take the hips up. Let's keep the knees bent to begin with, taking the upper body to the thighs. Nice stretch, and then just start to pedal through. If you do run, or you walk a lot, or any other kind of workout, you really feel it. It's just such a nice stretch. So remember, the focus here is to get that length through the spine. So if you're losing that length through the spine as you straighten the legs, then just rebend them. So pedal, wiggle your bum, wiggle, wiggle, and then just settle wherever you're comfortable in dog. Hold that hamstring stretch. Feel the strength through the arms and the shoulders. And breathe. Oh, it's just so nice. I've got the sun beating down on my arms. I feel like I was going to say something else then. Beating down on my arms. Sorry. And then coming forwards, bring the knees down and come back into a child's pose. Keep the arms extended to begin with. Just take a couple of deep breaths. Take the arms down by the side of the body. Let the shoulders release down. Slowly rolling up. Sort your hair out. Bring the palms together. Lower the